Yes! воду! Baczność! Szeregu, zbiórka! Szeregu, zbiórka! Gotów! Baczność! Tak jest! Baczność! Lądu! Szeregu! Zbiórka! Tak jest! Szeregu! Zbiórka!
Prime Minister has come back from his third and greatest journey, and he said,
"Szeregu! Zbiórka!"
of the Czechoslovakian problem, which has now been achieved, is, in my view,
"Szeregu! Zbiórka!"
the prelude to a larger settlement in which all Europe
can find peace.
This morning,
watch this.
Another talk with the German Chancellor, Herr Hitler. And here is the paper which bears his name as well as mine. Some of you perhaps have already heard what it contains, but I would just like to read it to you. We, the German Führer and Chancellor, and the British Prime Minister, I've had a further meeting today and are agreed in recognizing that the question of Anglo-German relations is of the first importance for the two countries and for Europe. We regard the agreement signed last night and the Anglo-German naval agreement as symbolic of the desire of our two peoples never to go to war with one another again. We are resolved that the method of consultation shall be the method adopted to deal with any other questions that may concern our two countries, and we are determined to continue our efforts to remove possible sources of difference and thus to contribute to assure the peace of Europe.
Thank you.
What's this?
Thank you.
yes!
And the constantly this country at war with Germany.
Come on, march! Discussing?
What a bitter blow this means. With all my lords cuddled to win seems to save it. Yet I cannot believe that there is anything more.
Yes!
It would have been more successful. Up to this very last, it would have been quite possible.
Samnon! Marsch!
An honorable settlement between Germany and Poland. But Hitler would not hesitate. He had evidently made up his mind to attack Poland for whatever happened. And although he now says he put forward reasonable
march!
The proposals were never shown to the firm. Not to us. And though they were announced,
what's those?
Hitler did not wait.
What's those?
In order to retreat across the Polish frontier in this morning. The action showed him
big. Ruszać się!
There is no chance of expecting that this man would
have been
inspected.
Priemy się! Renegu Skurka! Za mną! Marsz! Pod ostrzałem! Tak jest! Ruszać się! Za mną! Marsz! Renegu, z biurka! Za mną! Marsz! Ruszać się! Tak jest! Renegu, z biurka! Tak jest! Szeregu, biurka! Kryjemy się! Za mną! Marsz! Za mną! Marsz! Pod ostrzałem! Tak jest! Opasnost! Gotów! Baczność! Dowódco, wycofują się!
I am speaking to you. The cabinet room is in Danzig Street. This morning, the British ambassador in Berlin handed the German government a final note, stating that unless we heard from them by 11 o'clock, that they were prepared at once to withdraw their troops from Poland, a state of war would exist between us. I have to tell you now that no such undertaking has been received. And that consequently,
Zedego, Spiurka!
At war with Germany.
Baczność!
You can imagine.
Zedego, Spiurka!
It is to me that all my long struggle to win peace has failed. Yet I cannot believe that there is anything more.
Zedego, Spiurka!
That I could have done. And it would
have been. Zedego, Spiurka!
Up to the very last, it would have been quite possible to have arranged a peaceful and honorable settlement between Germany and Poland. But Hitler would not have it. He had evidently made up his mind to attack Poland whatever happened. And although he now says he put forward reasonable proposals which were rejected by the Poles, that is not a true statement. The proposals were never shown to the Poles, nor to us. And though they were announced in the German broadcast on Thursday night, Hitler did not wait to hear comments on them, but ordered his troops to cross the Polish frontier the next morning. His action shows convincingly that there is no chance of expecting that this man will ever give up his practice of using force to gain his will. He can only be stopped by force. And we in France are today, in fulfillment of our obligations, going to the aid of Poland, who is so bravely resisting this wicked and unprovoked attack upon her people. We have a clear conscience. We have done all that any country could do to establish.
Not to!
But the situation in which no word given by Germany's ruler could be trusted, and no people or country could feel itself safe,
not
to! Become intolerable. And now that we have resolved to finish it, I know that you will all play your part with calmness and courage.
What's next? Zedego, Spiurka! Spurka!
Ambassador in Berlin handed the German government the final note, stating that unless we heard from them by 11 o'clock, that they were prepared at once to withdraw their troops from Poland, a state of war would exist between us. I have to tell you now that no such undertaking has been received, and that consequently, this country is at war with Germany. You can imagine what a bitter blow it is to me that all my long struggle to win peace has failed. Yet I cannot believe that there is anything more or anything different that I could have done, and it would have been more successful. Up to the very last, it would have been quite possible to have arranged a peaceful, harmonious settlement between Germany and Poland. But Hitler would not have. He inevitably made up his mind to attack Poland, whatever happened. And although he now says he put forward reasonable proposals which were rejected by the Poles, that is not a true statement. The proposals were never killed to the Poles, nor blood. Though they were announced in the German Red Cross on Thursday night, Hitler did not wait to get their comment on and ordered his troops to cross the Polish frontier the next morning. His action shows convincingly that there is no chance of he can only be stopped by them. And we in France are today, in fulfillment of our obligation, going to the aid of Poland, who is so bravely resisting this wicked and unprovoked attack upon her. All that any country could do to establish peace. But a situation in which no word given by Germany's ruler could be trusted, and no people or country could feel itself safe, had become intolerable. And now that we have resolved to finish it, I know that you will all play your part with calmness and courage.
Ruszać się! Wycofać się! Pod ostrzałem! Bijemy się! Bijemy się! against us.
Watch us!
catch those?
Watch those!
Vice President, Speaker, members of the Senate, the House of Representatives, yesterday, December 7th, 1941, a date which will live in infamy. The United States of America was suddenly and deliberately attacked by naval and air forces of the Empire of Japan. The United States was at peace with that nation. And at solicitation of Japan, still in conversation with its government and its emperor, looking for the maintenance of peace in the Pacific. Indeed, 1 hour after Japanese air squadrons had commenced bombing in the American island of Oahu, the Japanese ambassador to the United States and his colleagues delivered to our Secretary of State a formal reply to a recent American message. And while this reply stated that it seemed useless to continue the existing diplomatic negotiations, it contained no threat or hint of war or of armed attack. It will be recorded that the distance of Hawaii from Japan makes it obvious that the attack was deliberately planned many days or even weeks ago. During the intervening time, the Japanese government has deliberately sought to deceive the United States by force and expression of hope for continued peace. The attack yesterday on the Hawaiian Islands has caused severe damage to American naval and military forces.
An angle, Smutka!
I regret to tell you that very many American lives have been lost. In addition, American ships have been reported torpedoed on the high seas between San Francisco and Honolulu. Yesterday, the Japanese government also launched attacks against Malaya. Last night, Japanese forces attacked Hong Kong. Last night, Japanese forces attacked Guam. Last night, Japanese forces attacked the Philippine Islands. Last night, Japanese attacked the Philippine Islands. And this morning, the Japanese attacked Midway Islands. Japan has therefore undertaken a surprise offensive extending throughout the Pacific area.
this is a talk on national security. Because the nub of the whole purpose of your president is to keep you now and your children later, your grandchildren much later, out of a last-ditch war for the preservation of American independence. And of all the things that American independence means, you, me,
Lord,
never before, since Jamestown, our American civilization been in such danger as now. The Nazi masters of Germany have made it clear that they intend not only to dominate all life and thought in their own country, but also to enslave the whole of Europe, and then to use the resources of Europe to dominate the rest of the world. In view of the nature of this undeniable threat, it can be asserted properly and categorically that the United States has no right or reason to encourage talk of peace until the day shall come when there is a clear intention on the part of the aggressor nations to abandon all
thought
of dominating or conquering the world. The forces of the states that are leagued against all people who live in freedom are being held away from our shores. Germans and Italians are being blocked the other side of the Atlantic by the British and by the Greeks and by thousands of soldiers and sailors who are able to escape from subjugated countries. The Japanese are being engaged in China, in Asia, by the Chinese Navy in another great defense. In the Pacific Ocean is our fleet. A gun loaded with explosive bullets, economic as well as military. Frankly and definitely, there is danger ahead. Danger against which we must prepare. But we well know that we cannot escape danger or the fear of it by crawling into bed and pulling the covers over our heads. Germany has said that she was occupying Belgium to save the Belgians from the British. Would she hesitate then to say to any South American country, we are occupying you
to
protect you from aggression by the United States? Belgium is being used as an invasion base against Britain, now fighting for its life. And any South American country in Nazi hands would always constitute a jumping-off place for German attack on any one of the other republics of this hemisphere. We think of Hawaii as an outpost of defense in the Pacific. Yet, the Azores are closer to our shores in the Atlantic than Hawaii is on the other side. Those who say that the Axis powers would never have any desire to attack the Western Hemisphere. This is the same dangerous form of wishful thinking which has destroyed the powers of resistance of so many conquered people. Let us no longer find ourselves. The undeniable fact of the evil forces which have crushed, undermined, and corrupted so many others are already within our own gates. Your government knows much about every day is perishing. Their secret emissaries are active in our own and neighboring countries. They seek to stir up suspicion and cause internal strife. They try to turn capital against labor and vice versa. They try to reawaken long, slumbering racial and religious enmity, which should have no place in this country. And there are also American citizens, many of them in high places, who unwittingly, in most cases, are aiding and abetting the work of these agents. I do not charge these American citizens with being foreign agents, but I do charge them with doing exactly the kind of work that the dictators want done in the United States. The experience in the past 2 years has proven beyond doubt that no nation can appease the Nazi. No man can tame a tiger into a kitten by stroking it. There can be no appeasement with ruthlessness. There can be no reasoning with an incendiary bomb.
Bunker!
Thank you.
Wacznost!
Zedegu! Bürger!
Thank you.
Wieczność!
And a man next time. I dominate you, you sluggish simpleton.
Oh, I'm burning! I'm burning! Fire! Fire! Fire!
Oh, yeah.
Point bang. Suck.
Meanwhile,
I do believe I'm on fire. Excellent.
Okay.
Watch those!